Dear students, today we will start with our chapter number 3, How a State Government Works. Last year we discussed the fact that government works at three level, local, state and national level. Local level like Panchayati Raj, in our grade 6th, we studied about it. In this year in grade 7th, we will be doing it at state government, at state level. In your grade 7th, you will do it at national level. Now come to the point, in this chapter we will examine the work of the government at state level, then how does this take place in a democracy, then question like what is the role of member of legislative assembly, MLAs and ministers, and how do people they express their views or demand actions from government. So these are the basic questions we are going to discuss in this chapter, and we will look at these questions through the example of health. Okay, first of all you should know the structure of government. What is the structure of government? There are three types of elections in India: Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and State Assembly elections. Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha is not our topic. Our topic is State Assembly elections. So we will be focusing on State Assembly elections. Okay, students, you know in this world there are lot many countries. As you know, so all the countries, they do not follow same system. They follow different system. So here we will be talking about three systems. As I told, countries, they follow different system. So three system. First is federal, unitary and confederal system. What is a federal system? Federal system of government is one that divides the power of government between the national government and state and local government. Here is the division of power at national level, state level and local level. Whereas unitary system, a system of political organization in which most or all the governing power resides in a centralized government. Who has all power? Center has all power. Third is confederal system. Confederal system is totally different than federal and unitary system. In this system, it is a kind of loose relationship among a number of smaller political units. The vast majority of political power rests with the local government. And the central federal government has a very little power. So your confusion will be clear in the next slide. So I'll make you understand in very simple way. As I told you, federal system divides power. In federal system, power is divided into central and state level. According to the constitution, some powers are with state, some powers are with center. So which country has a federal system? You should know our own country, India. India has federal system. India follows this system. In India, power is divided. Some power state has and some power is with center. Like we have CMs, PM, Prime Minister, then Sarpanch, Panchayati Raj and many other ministers. So in this way, this is an example that in India, federal system is followed, where power is divided into central and state government. But there are some issues like drinking and smoking, age of drinking. So some such kind of issues can be taken by both central and state. Okay, let us move to the unitary system. What is the unitary system? In unitary system, center has all the power. Who is the strongest part? Center. Center has all the power in unitary system. The example is China. So whatever the government, whatever the decision government will take, it will apply on everyone. It will apply on each state in China. Next, third one is confederal system. What is confederal system? It is different than federal and unitary system. How? In this system, state has choice to follow the government. It is the decision of the state. If they want to follow a government, they can follow. If they want to follow center, they can follow. Otherwise, they can be independent. So mainly the stronger states they usually work as independent. They work independently. So example of such country is Soviet Union. Example of unitary system is China. Okay, your next topic is Government of India. So So government of India, when we talk about government of India, there are three levels: legislature, executive and judiciary. Again students, here judiciary, again here judiciary and executive is not our topic. Today our discussion is on legislature. As we are doing about state government, so our main topic of discussion is legislature. Okay, so all of you must be knowing about parliament. Parliament has two houses, upper house and lower house. To upper house we say Rajya Sabha and to lower house we say Lok Sabha. Lot many students, they get confused like which is lower house, which is upper house, Rajya Sabha or Lok Sabha. So there is a simple trick to learn this. L stands for lower and L stands for Lok. So learn this: Lok Sabha, lower house, L, and automatically upper house is Rajya Sabha. Now, next is a Council of States. How to remember this? Which is Council of State and which is Council of People? Council of State is upper house. Council of People is lower house. How to remember this? See this Rajya Sabha. What is the meaning of Rajya? Rajya is state. We say Rajya as state. So Rajya Sabha is Council of State. This is Lok Sabha. Lok means people. So Council of People means Lok Sabha. Now students, as it is clear from the name, like this is Council of State. It is clear that in Council of State, the representatives will represent state in the parliament. Whereas in Lok Sabha, it is Council of People, and here the representative will present the views and the problems of common people in the parliament. And who represent both states and common people in assembly, we call them MPs. I hope this is clear to you. Okay, let us move to the next topic. Oh, one thing is left. Yes, here. So upper house, Rajya Sabha, Council of States. Now who elects them? Who elect the member of upper house and this Rajya Sabha? The members are elected by the MLAs. MLA. Who is MLA? For this, refer next slide. Who is MLA? First of all, just read the statements. Read these sentences. Member of Legislative Assembly are elected by the people. Who is called MLA? M stands for member. L for legislative. A for assembly. Member of Legislative Assembly. They are elected by people. People give vote and they elect them. Number two, every state in India has Legislative Assembly. If you are talking about 28 states and 9 union territories, all of them have Legislative Assembly. Each state is divided into different areas or constituencies. Constituencies, it is clear, it means areas. Areas. Then one representative is elected from each constituency and become a member of Legislative Assembly. If there are lot many areas in a state, there are lot many small constituencies. So from every constituency, there will be one MLA. Now candidate who stand and get elected in an assembly election, they are from different parties. Okay, so as we discussed that from each of the constituencies, many candidates they stand in the election. Out of those, only one candidate who secured the maximum number of votes and who win, he become member of Legislative Assembly. So let us study the case of Himachal Pradesh in the assembly election of 2012. In your book, the same example is given of Himachal Pradesh in the assembly election of 2007. I am considering here 2012. Why? So that after listening this video, I want the students to open the book and to review the example given in your book and evaluate in the same way I'll be doing this example. Okay. So let us see view the result of the elections in Legislative Assembly of Himachal Pradesh in 2012. Students, first of all, okay, let us study the case of Himachal Pradesh in the assembly election of 2012. Himachal Pradesh has 68 constituencies. How many constituencies? 68. constituencies means small, small areas. Now, from each of these constituencies, you can see, you can refer this map. These different yellow, blue, green area, the borders are there. So, these are the constituencies. So, from each of these constituencies, many candidates, they stand for the election, out of which only one candidate who is secured with the maximum number of votes, he will become the MLA. First of all, let us view the result of election, Himachal Pradesh Legislative Assembly's election 2012. See, in order to gain majority in the election, a political party needed to win more than 34 seats. It should be more than 34 seats. There are 68 constituencies. So who will get more votes, maximum votes? He will become the MLA. So see, in order to gain majority in the election, a political party needed to win more than 34 seats. How many? More than 34 seats. So from this electoral results, we find that the Indian National Congress, what we are getting here, Indian National Congress, out of 68, how many number of MLAs are elected? 36. It had 36 MLAs elected by public. Hence, it formed the ruling party. Now, Indian National Congress is getting more votes, more than 34, 36 votes. So, this Indian National Congress, INC, will be considered as ruling party. Now, as the BJP was the next largest party, after this, who is getting more? BJP. After Indian National Congress, BJP is getting more votes, more MLAs, 26 MLAs. So, therefore, this will be considered as opposition party, including those who had been elected as independent candidates. Now, they are also considered to be the opposition party, but the major is BJP. Now, the MLAs of majority party. Majority party means, which is the majority party? INC. Now, the MLAs of INC, they will elect their leader. Like in this election in 2012, the INC, Indian National Congress, they elected their leader as CM Veer Bhadra Singh. He was the CM, he was elected as CM Chief Minister in 2012. Now, how he is appointed? This is a basic question. Who appoints CM? CM is appointed by the governor. Governor, who is governor, head of state? CM is appointed by the governor. You should know this. Now, next is, he has a list of those MLAs of the governor who he wanted to become minister. So when he will be appointed as a CM, he must be having the list of those MLAs to the governor whom he wanted to become the minister. Ministers like education minister, health minister of the state. So the governor, he appointed those MLAs as ministers also. I hope this topic is clear to you. So what we studied in this topic, we studied about how the people, they get majority of votes. Then number two is the different political name of the different political parties. Number three, who is ruling party and what is opposition party, right? Who are independent? Independent means those who do not belong to any party. So yes, one more thing. Political party is able to win a majority of seats. So in such a case, it obtains support of one or more other than one party. So sometime like they get votes, like if, for example, if it is 36, they should have 34 votes. So what is happening? Sometime they're getting like 33, 32. Means very nearby. So none of the political party is able to win a majority of the seat. In such case, इट अबटेन सपोर्ट ऑफ वन और मोर देन वन पार्टी एंड देन दे कंबाइन टू फॉर्म द मेजॉरिटी इन हाउस इन सच गवर्नमेंट वॉट वील कॉल टू दिस गवर्नमेंट वी कॉल इट एज कोलिशन गवर्नमेंट. Okay, now see, after the election, now elections are done, which I told you, after the elections, the MLAs belonging to the ruling party will elect the leader who will become the chief minister. Like in this case, Congress leader Veerbhadra, he took the oath for record 6th term as Himachal chief minister, Himachal Pradesh chief minister. The chief minister and other ministers, they have the responsibility of running various government departments or ministers. You know what, actually, sometimes they handle means dual responsibility. They act as a minister also, so they act as a MLA also. So sometimes MLA have dual responsibility, one as an MLA and other as a minister. We will be doing about this in our further slides. So your next topic is example. Next, as I told you that we will be covering this chapter with one example, right? So in order to understand the working of the government of state at state level, we will be visualizing it as a session in the legislative assembly, and there will be 6 MLAs. For that, I advise students to see next video.